May 3rd, Jay, back in 2006. Let's take you back. NBA playoffs, first round, game 5. LeBron James and the Cavs taking on Gilbert Arenas and the Wizards. The series is tied at 2. The Wizards are down by 4. Antoine Jameson misses the floater, but Caron Butler getting the rebound and the finish. And now the Wizards are within 2. 16 seconds left. Inbounds to LeBron. Up court, and LeBron turns it over. Oh, no. The Wizards push the ball. Antonio Daniels to Butler. Butler layup. Tie game. 107. Wizards had trailed since 3:15 remaining in the fourth, but here they are on the verge of taking it to overtime. 7 seconds left. A chance for the Cavs to win it. LeBron, is he going to be the hero? He takes it himself. He pulls up. LeBron for the win. No good. We are headed to overtime. Under 10 seconds left now in the OT. It's a one-point game. The Wizards trail. Arenas drives. He's fouled hard on the shot. With 3 seconds left, he goes falling to the floor, but he gets up. He's okay. He goes to the line. First free throw, and that is good. And now we have a tie ball game again. And the second free throw is good. So the Wiz up by 1, the 8th lead change in the overtime after a Cleveland timeout. Last chance once again for the Cavs with 3 seconds left. This time, LeBron drives baseline, splits the defenders, and makes the game-winning shot. The full court heave, no go for Washington. Cleveland wins it 121-120, his only field goal in overtime. LeBron finishes with 45 points, 14-23 from the floor. They go on to win the series in 6 games. Which brings us to some more LeBron clutch playoff moments. Why not? I mean, who do you think is the greatest clutch player of all time in the NBA? Because it could be LeBron, MJ, yes. Kobe. Yes. What about Mr. Clutch, Jerry West?
Yes.
All right. All of them possessing the clutch gene in large measure.
But today, let's talk about LeBron.
Okay.
In the last 20 seasons, LeBron tied for the second most clutch points in a single postseason. And over the last 5 seasons, he's shooting 47% from the floor in clutch time.
So you figured all that out on your own,
right? I did. It was back in the brain somewhere. Look at some of his clutch playoff moments in his career. May 2009 against the Magic. Pass, top of the key, boom. Drains the 3 at the buzzer for the win. The crowd goes crazy. LeBron turns and goes crazy. Yes.
I love that.
Magic coach Stan Van Gundy not going crazy. He's just like,
That's life.
Magic won the series, though.
All right, May 22nd. 2013 Eastern Conference Finals Game 1, all those Pacers Heat battles, and Miami down with 2.2 seconds left, but LeBron with the drive and the score as time expired, just going right past Paul George there and getting to the rim as the Heat win by 1 and win the series in 7.
2015 Eastern Conference Semis against the Bulls, game tied at 84, 1.5 seconds left. LeBron gets the inbound, fires up the shot at the buzzer. Over Jimmy Butler, the Chicago crowd is stunned. Cavs win by 2. They went on to win the series in 6 games.
June 19th, 2016, Game 7 NBA Finals, tied late in the fourth. The Warriors on the run. Andre Iguodala goes up for the layup, but LeBron, the chase down block, his signature move. Here's how it sounded on the call from Mike Breen.
Iguodala to Curry, back to Iguodala, up for the layup. Oh, blocked by James. LeBron James with the rejection.
That was crazy. April 2018 against the Pacers. We're tied at 95, 3 seconds left. LeBron gets the ball, 2 dribbles, drops it at the buzzer. The clutch 3. Cavs win by 3. They went on to win the series in 7 games.
And finally, May 5th, 2018, Eastern Conference Semis. Cavs, Raptors tied at 103, 8 seconds left. LeBron up court, goes to his left, throws up the one-handed floater at the buzzer. Are you kidding me? Such a tough shot. I mean, he's going full speed to his left, gets the one-handed shot up with the right hand. Cavs win 105-103 to sweep the Raptors.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.